In this video, I will show you how to DIY that self-powered Zener diode and LED tester by using 4 AA batteries, a mini digital voltage meter, and a few recycled parts. Counting the numbers of turns for this inductor. No, I am not going to use this one, not that one, and nor to this. Counting the numbers of turns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and 25. Chosen this one. Now preparing to make another winding coil. To join the one end of wire with the one of this inductor's terminals by soldering together and name it as number 2. Name the inductor's other terminal as number 3. Making a new coil now and make sure its winding direction is the same as the inductor's coil direction. New coil has 6 turns, and name this terminal, which has been held by hand, as number 1. This is a new transistor, type of D1682, with a heatsink attached. That is a fast recovery diode, type of FR207, which can be replaced by an ordinary diode. This is a set of capacitor, with capacity of 100 volt, and 0.2 μF. That is a k ohms or so resistor. That is a mini digital voltage meter. It can measure DC 0 to 100 volt voltage, and needs DC 4 to 30 volt power supply. This is a pair of measurement accessory. Each has a hook on the tip of the one end. That is a recycled, modified circuit board with a tactile switch on it. All the part will be soldered on this circuit board, except a pair of the accessory. Additional parts, a small piece of board. AA type battery pack. Each pack can store 2 AA batteries. Two battery packs are needed. And some screws as well. The parts have been soldered on that circuit board. It will sit on the board like this, with 2 AA battery packs. The circuit board and battery packs have been secured on the wood board, and the parts have been connected according to following diagram. Two AA battery packs are here, and showed there in the diagram. a transistor. Type of D1682 is showed here in the diagram. The coils, or inductor just behind the transistor, is showed there in the diagram. That is the tactile switch, showed here in the diagram. This is a fast recovery diode, showed there in the diagram. That is a k ohms or so resistor, showed here in the diagram. A 0.2 μF capacitor is there. A DC mini digital voltage meter is showed here. Two of those are tester stands, the place where Zener diode or LED leave there to be tested. Incidentally, in order to make the mini digital voltage meter to work, the supply its voltage range is between DC 4 and 30 volt, so the 6 volt AA batteries is for the purpose. However, the transistor, coils, and other parts made up the circuit, which needs only DC 1.5 volt to work. Those are the circuit's wires connected. The battery pack switches are here, and showed there in the diagram. Now the tester is ready to use. Switch the battery packs on. The mini digital voltage meter is on. Push the tactile on. The mini digital voltage meter indicated 83.6 volt. Normally, you should get the voltage range between 75 and 90 volt. To test this Zener diode, it showed 5 volt. So this is 5 volt Zener diode. To test this Zener diode, it showed 12 volt. So this is 12 volt Zener diode. To test the Zener diode likes this one. A pair of accessory come in handy. And showing here for getting it connected for testing. It showed 18 volt. So this is 18 volt Zener diode. To test this LED, it showed 2 volt. So this is 2 volt LED. That's it. Now you've known how to DIY this type of Zener diode and LED tester, and how to use it friendly. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment and subscribe if you've enjoyed the video. Your encouragement is my motivation.